follow rules, we not like the rest. Type to break a record and won't break a sweat. Heard your last attempt, we wasn't feeling that. It's over, man, it's over, game. It's time to bring the feeling back.
Yes, there you go.
Won't follow rules, we not like the rest. Type to break a record and won't break a sweat.
My name is Jay Solano. Typically, I'm behind the scenes of Dragon Pharma, filming and creating content for them, but for the first time, I'm in front of the camera. I'm 29 years old. I've been a videographer for Dragon Pharma for about 3.5 years, and I'm a powerlifter. I started my career as a full-time videographer about 5 years ago, and for the past 3, I have dedicated it to Dragon Pharma. One of the first videos that we actually filmed was back in summer of 2018, and that was of Bahar. So it's been nice witnessing everything firsthand of how much the brand has evolved since then. The reason I'm here today is because I'm gonna let you guys in on the journey of a powerlifter as I get ready to compete in my 7th USAPL competition, which is going to be at the Arnold in less than 5 weeks. This is something the channel hasn't seen yet, so let's talk about powerlifting. I started powerlifting back in 2016. I was already 23 at that time, so you can say I started a little bit late in the game. But before that, I have already been going to the gym and doing regular stuff for like two years. But it wasn't until one of my friends, Max, he introduced me to powerlifting. He told me what it was all about, and that's when I found out that powerlifting is just transport where you lift the most amount of weight for a single rep in your squat, bench, and deadlift. Now, when I found that out, to me, it seemed so interesting, so different. And I finally had something to look forward to. From then, I started the famous Candido 6-week program, and we just took off from there. I fell in love with the training and the powerlifting lifestyle, and here we are now, 5 years later. I competed for the first time in 2017, so it was really only 6 months after I started powerlifting. And of course, going into a first competition, I was nervous, but I was also excited. But one thing that stood out to me the most was the environment, the energy in the whole venue. Like, I went into that meet not knowing anybody, but literally everybody was cheering at everybody, even if you didn't know them. Even if you were squatting 50 pounds or 500 pounds, everybody was giving you the same energy and the platform. I liked it. It was such a welcoming environment. And that's exactly why after that competition, I competed 5 more times. After my first competition, it was a great experience and all, but I knew I had more in me. So I figured if I just stay consistent a few more years, I can get stronger. So that's what I tried to do. And for me, staying consistent with powerlifting was pretty easy because I love the training and I fell in love with the progress. And because powerlifting is such a numbers game, it's pretty easy to keep track of the numbers that you want to achieve like month after month. The sport of powerlifting is all about increasing your numbers and just getting stronger. And that's something that I truly fell in love with, the progress. I'm glad I stayed consistent since back in 2017, because as of my last meet, I have increased my squat to 584, benched 385, and deadlift 622. In a way, I got addicted to getting stronger, and I have some plans for the next competition. Like for every other powerlifter, going into a competition, the main goal is always to do better than your previous meet, to get a better total, increase your total. So on my previous meet, I totaled 1576. So the major goal going into the Arnold is going to be to finally break into the 1600s. And from there on, just continue to climb up the ladder in my weight class. Now, let me show you guys a little bit behind the scenes of what goes on here at Dragon Pharma HQ. So let's show them this little teaser that we have. So any content that you guys see on YouTube or Instagram is done by that team here. We have our other videographer who's helping me film this, Pedro. Say hi to the people, Pedro.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Pedro. I'm the other videographer here at Dragon Pharma.
What's up, you guys? My name is Xavier, and Jay's brother.
And I am also the media director here at Dragon Pharma. I also run the Dragon Army, which is our affiliate program. And it's going to be exciting to take you guys through Jay's journey to the Arnold. And it's going to be interesting to show you guys a little bit of what goes behind the scenes here at Dragon Pharma.
What we're going to do now is we're going to get our meals in, and then later on we're going to go to a gym. And we're going to go to a powerlifting gym, so it's going to be a little bit different. There, we're actually going to be able to make noise, use chalk, and be as loud as we want. Right now, my body weight is around 183. I don't have to cut really any weight, just like 2 pounds for competition day. So I really take advantage of that. And that's why going to me, I consume about the same amount of food, and that's around 3,000 calories a day. We're going to finish this meal, and then we're going to head to the gym, because today we actually have a pretty heavy deadlift day. And I'm gonna take you, I'm not gonna show you guys everything, but we're gonna take you through the top set, and you guys will see that at the gym. Hey. All right, so now we are at my home gym, Boeing Barbell Center in Boeing Beach. And I joined this gym right after the gyms in Florida started reopening again. So I think it's been about already like a year and a half. And this is honestly the gym for any competitor powerlifter. That's really like all you need. We have competition racks, competition plates, and competition bars. Like I was saying before, the federation, there's a couple federations in the United States, but the one that I compete in is the USAPL. That's the federation that I done all my 6 meets in. And recently, a couple months ago, they actually announced that they are going to have a pro series, which is basically the same thing as NPC IFBB. They're gonna give the opportunity for powerlifters to earn their pro card. So that's something to look forward to, something that gets me excited to see. Hopefully I can get there one day. Now the USAPL, it's a test federation. So, and believe it or not, there has been a few scenarios in the past where lifters take a certain supplement and then it turns out to be contaminated and they actually fail their drug test. But I've been taking Venom for the past 3 years, since I started working with Dragon. I've been taking the pre-workout, that has been the only pre-workout that I've taken. And in my past 2 meets, I've gotten tested, everything has been good. So for any lifters competing in a test federation, you can definitely trust Venom. We not like the rest. Type to break a record and won't break a sweat. Heard your last attempt, we wasn't feeling that. It's over, ain't no Novocaine. It's time to bring the feeling back. We don't follow rules, we not like the rest. Type to break a record and won't break a sweat. Heard your last attempt, we wasn't feeling that. It's over, ain't no Novocaine. Right now we have 385 on the bar. And it may look a little bit different because those are actually competition plates. So each plate weighs about like 55 pounds. Everything's in kilograms. I'm gonna continue to warm up, and we're gonna work up to a heavy set of just a single rep actually. So we're aiming towards anything around 600, around there. We'll see. How cool is this? So you guys know that meme about powerlifters taking forever on their sets? It's true. Learn how to listen, and every real leader's got a vision. So learn how to play your poetry in motion like a pick and roll or a give and go. But we ain't hitting shots though, we keep hitting goals. We in the different zone, you know. We go hard like what's an off day. 25 ain't okay, that's what they all say. Stay focused, big vision. Go hard, be different. We on the way to the top. So, 2 essentials in powerlifting: ammonia and baby powder. We're gonna use this when we go for our top set, but right now we're gonna use the baby powder for this. So at a competition, you are actually allowed to use baby powder on your and your legs. So I'm gonna put them right here. And this just helps for people who have a little bit thicker thighs. Sometimes the bar can get stuck, but with this, the bar can easily just slide through the legs. It helps a little bit. So we're gonna put some there. And a reminder, try not to spread baby powder inside of the gym, because that can actually cause people to slip on the platform. So do it in an area where people are not really gonna step on. Come on. So right now we have 584 on the bar. This is gonna be one of the last warm-ups, and depending how this feels, I mean, they're gonna go up to 606 or a little bit higher than that. But we're gonna see how this moves right now. Oh! All right. Yep, that felt easy. We're gonna go up. So I'm supposed to do a certain way for one rep, RPA, meaning that after I do the one repetition, I should have two more reps in the tank, but of course not do those two reps. I'm not supposed to go extremely heavy. Like, let's say going RPE 10, or that's like going like your maximum strength, but we're not gonna do that today because we're still 4.5 weeks out. So I think we're gonna go with 622.
So you just did it, or you gonna do it?
I'm about to.
Okay, all right.
You think you can do it?
What's that?
You think you can do it?
Oh yeah, I think you can, yeah.
By the way, I'm in the presence of a powerlifting legend.
No.
Every day we chasing.
No, I'm just a little guy hanging around, that's all.
Squat 700 pounds.
Yeah.
Taking the lead, we don't follow. We need it now, not tomorrow. Don't care what they say, not changing the pace. Working too hard to be last in the race. Yeah. So time in the day, and it ain't never waste. Working this hard to be one of the great. Yeah. Whatever it takes, put that on the plate. Life is a game, but we raising the stakes. Moving the bar up so high. Been on our grind for life.
Up,
so bright.
We should
be trying to sound cool, but we trying to be common. Hard work pays off, that's perfect timing. Changing the world with this rhyme and it's priceless. We got the nicest by putting the time in. Can't be the greatest, you're not even trying. What now? We on the chase to the sundown.
So that right there was 622. And that's matching my all-time one rep max, my all-time PR. Last time I did that type of weight was November 2020. And that was at a competition. So me being able to do 622 again this early into prep is a really good sign that things are going the right way. And that's gonna wrap it up for episode one. The next episode, we're going to go a little bit more in depth about the training, a little bit more of squat and bench. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoy this type of content, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys on episode two.
All I can see is the finish line. Started, I gotta finish mine. It's get it time, anytime, hella long. I've been alive, I didn't mind it all. Waking bake, won't take a break at all. That's on my word, my boss. Lights gon' have to pay me twice, or pay me no mind, and I don't mind it all. My grind is great, I am my job to inspire. I'm right behind, go take line, it's been fired by a change.
But every time I ain't get hired, second week kicked in, I probably won't get tired. Kevin Gates or Kevin Bacon, only 6 degrees of separation between me and the next level of elevation.